If you knew where your food comes from and what it means for your health, would you eat more of it? Jason Ott and Nora Munoz with the Texas A&M Agrilife Extension hope that you do. Guys, it's great having you in here. Let's get right into it. The recipes that are in here, this is a new book, so it's all locally sourced food.
Right, correct. So this is a new book from what we've had before. So they are all Texas commodities, and they feature very nutritious, easy to prepare meals that you'd want to share with your family and your friends.
I love it. And this is what's so neat about this fundraiser is a chance for people to come out and learn about exactly where did that green bean come from, and the theme surf to turf. A surf and turf this year. I mean, you get to see where farmers are out there bringing in all the goods.
Right, that's exactly right. On April the 14th, we're going to have our Path to the Plate Dinner Tonight program, and folks are going to be able to not only learn how to enjoy and cook a healthy, nutritious meal, but they're also going to learn about where agricultural commodities actually come from. All of the commodities in this book are grown here in Texas, and we're focusing on three that'll be produced specifically in Nueces County.
Here in Nueces County. Second year for the event. What do you want people to come away with? I'm flipping through this. I see some great desserts in here already. The spicy pasta rigatoni looks good, and then you have a vegetable cowboy roasted potatoes and green beans. I mean, it's all this stuff in this book.
So we do have some sides in there, entrees and desserts, of course, and we want people to understand that meal prepping is not hard. You know, when you cook at home, you control what is in your food. So whether you're controlling it just to be healthier or because you've got a chronic illness or sensitivities, allergies, you're controlling that, which is hard to control outside your home environment.
And I think it's also really important because if you show your children how to cook this way, they'll carry that on later.
Correct, and we focus a lot on family meal time, so how do you get your children involved, even from little ones to older ones in the kitchen with you?
And just like we were saying before the break here, that you start things early. You can maybe get a slow cooker, throw all the goods in there.
And correct. And you know, the beginning part of that is just having a recipe list or your recipes and a list of groceries, making sure you have that at home. Makes it easier to know that you've got everything there when you get home.
All the information is on the screen right now. It is Saturday, April 14th. We'll have all of that on our website at KFLITV.com. It's so great to have you guys back in here for the second visit. Look forward to this, going through this menu. What a great resource. Thank you so much for what you do in the area and keeping people healthy and letting them know it's easy to be healthy.
Thank you for having us.